So guys, welcome to the lecture one. And today we discuss what is a input and output. And we also discuss what is a variables and what is a data types. So first we discuss input and output. So what is a input? Input is a basically taking data from user. Okay. So in C++, basically we are using Cin to taking the input. Okay. Now come to the output. Output is a basically displaying data. Okay. By using cout function. And these input and output are belong to the iostream libraries in C++. And you can see here the syntax of input and output in C++ by using this cout function. We want to just print hello world. Okay. We just want to print hello world by using this cout function. Okay. Suppose we want to take some input by user. So first we need to make a variable. Variable is basically num. Okay. And by using this cin function, we're taking the input in the this num, okay, num variable. Okay, and you can see the example here. Okay, so basically first we declared our variable age, and we are taking input in the age variable by using this cin function. Okay, cin function, and we want to print this age by using this cout function. Okay, so come to the variables. What is the variables? So variable is basically a variable is a named storage that hold data in a memory. Okay, what is the rules for naming variables? So variables can contain letter, digits and underscores. Cannot start with a digit. Okay, variable cannot be start with the digit. Okay, no spaces or special symbols are allowed in the variable, and variable are also case sensitive. So come to the syntax of variable. Okay, so first we need to define data types. Okay, and then the variable name. Okay, and suppose we initialize with the sum value. Okay, so you can see the example here. Okay, so you can see here first we declared our variable age. Okay, and in this age variable we just put the 21. Okay, now this value become 21 of the age variable. Okay, and this is the age is basically integer variable, so we need to make a integer data types here. Okay, and you can see here this is a float value, so we need to make a data types is the basically float. Okay, so this price is the basically here variable. Okay, and types of variable is a float. Okay, this is the types of variable. Okay, and you can see here grade. Okay, in this grade variable we just store here characters. Okay, so this is the character data types, and similar here you can see here. And we want to print all the variable. Okay, so we just use this cout function. Okay, and print our age first, then price, then grade, and is passed. Okay, is passed is basically stored the true value. This is a basically boolean variable. And come to the data types. Okay, so data types is basically defined types and size of data stored in the variable. Okay, so suppose we make a variable first, this one x, and it contain 10. Okay, so we need to declare what is a 10. Okay, 10 is a basically contain the integer value. Okay, so we need to make this one integer type. Okay, data types, first one is a integer, and the integer basically have 4 byte. Okay, and second one is a float. Okay, float have also 4 byte, and third is a double. Double is a basically double of the float. Okay, so it contain the 8 byte stories. And next one is a char, and next one is a bool. Okay, so bool contain the boolean value true or false. Okay, and this is the other data types, string and the void. Okay, and come to the syntax of data types. So first we declared our data type first, then variable name, then some value here. Okay, this is a data types. Okay, so you can see the example here also. Okay, so first this is a basically data types, and this is a basically integer num, and this is the basically value 100. Okay, so basically we store 100 in the num variable. Okay, similar in this one. Okay, and similar this one, and similar this one, and similar this string name. Okay, so basically we just print first num. Okay, this num variable, then this pi variable, then this big number, then grade, then is true, and a name. Okay. Okay, so I think so we print all the value here. Okay, I think so it's clear to everyone. So thank you.